Yes, we had one of the more severe, potentially disruptive geomagnetic storms that we've seen in about a 10-year period as a pair of solar flares ejected from the sun on Sunday morning arrived at the Earth's magnetic field, or its magnetosphere, on Tuesday morning. And the way they interact with the Earth's magnetic field is what it essentially leads to seeing these colorations of yellows, greens, and also reds, and they get deflected out towards the polar regions. This particular event being so strong, we had the ability to see that across some of the lower latitudes of the world, at least a little farther south than what you typically would see. But the most common colors are the colors of green there as they the particles begin to collide with oxygen. That is typically what you see. We saw that around portions of New Zealand in the past 24 hours. A little less common is when you have the blues, the violets, the purples, as we have the particles colliding with nitrogen. And then you get up to the rarest of the types, the red coloration. And this is where high-altitude oxygen interacts with the particles of the solar flare once it arrives across the Earth. But that was the perspective on Tuesday. The area as far as the viewing points, as far south is really the northern portion of the United States, the Midwestern U.S., the Northeastern U.S. Notice portions of Northwestern Europe from Glasgow out there towards Oslo. St. Petersburg also had the potential to see some of this. And we certainly know we've seen video coming out of New Zealand, Christchurch to Hobart, some of the other viewing areas of interest with this unusual and powerful solar event that we saw in the past 24 hours. But typically, 10 p.m. to 2 a.m., the best time to see it, clear nights, far away from major city light pollution, the best setup as well. And around March and September, the equinox period, also a good time to see it, and hence why it's a good time right now if you have the possibility to get outside and take a look.